Let me ask you a strange question.
Is it possible for something as simple as a coffee machine, of all things, to almost cripple an entire company? Sounds ridiculous, right? But it happened. So a while back, we heard of how a major company had its internal systems breached all because of a vulnerable Wi-Fi enabled machine. That's right. Cyber criminals didn't go after the firewalls. They didn't hack the servers. Instead, they found a sneaky way into the system through an unsecured IoT coffee machine. This breach I'm talking about cost the company millions of dollars in damages, and it all stemmed from something so simple, something that could easily be overlooked. Now, this isn't a horror story about a coffee machine, though it easily could be. It's about how overlooking certain things in cybersecurity can have massive consequences. And speaking of oversight, let's talk about something that can also be a massive pitfall: getting the wrong cybersecurity certification. Yes, but why are we talking about this, you might want to ask? Well, you're just starting your career in cybersecurity, or even when you're trying to level up, it's so easy to fall into the trap of choosing the wrong certifications, ones that won't actually help you get ahead, but instead waste your energy and your money. The truth you might not hear often enough is that not all certifications are created equal. Some sound amazing, promising to boost your resume and land you high-paying job, but in reality, they don't hold much weight in the industry. Imagine investing months into a course, thinking it's your ticket to success, only to realize when you start applying for jobs that nobody is asking for it. It's like running a marathon only to find out you are headed in the wrong direction the whole time. So, in this video, you will discover the worst cybersecurity certifications you should avoid if you really want to build a solid, successful career in cybersecurity. But that's not all. While we discuss the certifications you should be avoiding, I'm going to drop insight on what you should focus on instead. What certifications will actually boost your career and make you a hot commodity in the cybersecurity job market. My name is Tolulope Michael, and I've spent years in this industry helping people like you start and grow careers in cybersecurity. Today, I'm going to help you avoid some of the most common mistakes I've seen people make when choosing certifications. And I promise you, by the end of this video, you will know exactly what to look out for and how to make sure every minute and dollar you spend on your education pays off. And if I deliver on this promise, please don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel for loaded videos like this. Now, buckle up, because we're about to uncover some truth that could save you from wasting precious time and energy. Let's get right into it. Before we get into the worst certifications to avoid, let's talk about why these certifications exist in the first place. Now, a lot of you think, hey, the fancier the name, the better the certification, right? That's wrong. Wrong certifications like Certified Cloud Defense Engineer might sound impressive, but they're not recognized by most employers. In fact, some recruiters and hiring managers don't even know what they are. Imagine walking into an interview, flashing your Certified Expert Network Defender badge, and the hiring manager has never even heard of it. Now, what happens next? They smile, nod, and politely steer the conversation toward the certifications they do care about, like CISSP, CISM, or CEH, certifications that people have heard of, and more importantly, are recognized by industry leaders. But here is the thing: the fancy certifications are marketed to people just like you, people who are new to cybersecurity and don't know which cert hold weight in the real world. And that reminds me of this guy I heard about called Mike. Mike was someone who, like many of you, wanted to break into cybersecurity. He was sold on this flashy sounding certification called Global Cybersecurity Sentinel. The description made it sound like it was the key to unlocking top cybersecurity jobs. But here's the reality: nobody in the industry recognized or have even heard about it. After Mike spent $2,000 on certification, attending 6 weeks on classes, and spending countless hours studying, Mike realized too late that he had essentially wasted his time and money. His LinkedIn messages from recruiters were not rolling in like he expected, and when he finally got an interview, they were more interested in whether he had a CEH or Computer Security Plus certification. Now, the lesson for you here is that sometimes the flashier the certification, the more likely it's not worth it. Don't get carried away with names and labels, okay? So, another trap I see a lot of people fall into is what I like to call the vendor-specific certification problem. Now, there's nothing wrong with vendor-specific certifications like AWS Certified Security Specialist or Microsoft Azure Security Engineer. These are useful, but only if you're specifically targeting jobs within those ecosystems. Another story some of you might find all too familiar is the one I heard about a cybersecurity analyst. Now, let's call her Sarah, who invested heavily in an IBM-focused cybersecurity certification because the company she worked for used IBM product. She thought it would give her access to other jobs in cybersecurity. But when it came time to look for a new job, she realized that most other companies didn't care about the IBM cert. They were looking for general certifications that could apply to any system. So while Sarah, like Mike, had mistakenly invested time and money into mastering this one specific vendor's ecosystem, her skills were not as transferable as she thought. I said all of that to say, if you're new to cybersecurity or looking to expand your career options, steer clear of vendor-specific cert unless you're committed to that particular tech stack. Now, this is the part where you might ask, so what makes a certification worth it? Three simple things: recognition, practical skills, and demand. Okay, maybe they are not so simple after all, since a lot of people tend to get it wrong, but let's break that down. I said number one is recognition, and this just simply means employers have to know the certification exists. If they don't, it's useless. This is why certifications like CISSP and CEH are so valuable. They are recognized across the board by hiring managers and recruiters. These certs are almost expected in some cybersecurity roles, so it will do your career a lot more good to pursue them. Then number two is practical skills. So in this aspect, one question you need to answer is, does this certification teach you things you will actually use on the job? Now, certifications like OSCP, that is Offensive Security Certified Professional, put you through hands-on labs that mirror real-world scenarios. When you finish OSCP, you're not just someone who memorized a textbook. You're someone who knows how to break into networks, exploit vulnerabilities, and defend systems. Then lastly, but of equal importance, is the demand for that certification. The question to answer here is, are people hiring roles that require this certification? So look at the job market. You might think that because a certification is new, it's going to be in high demand soon, but that's not always the case. If you're considering a certification, do a quick job search to see how many positions ask for it. If the answer is not many, it's probably not worth your time. Let me give you an example of what happens when you chase a certification that is too new. There is this certification called Certified Threat Intelligence Analyst. When it came out newly, people were excited because it seemed like a big deal. The problem a lot of them didn't realize in that time was that not enough companies were looking for it. People got the certification, and when they applied for jobs, they realized that hiring managers didn't really care about it yet. This is a common trap. Sometimes a new certification seems like it will be the next big thing, right? But it can take years for the market to catch up. In the meantime, you're stuck with a cert that employers are not looking for. Now, let's talk about certifications that are too easy. Sure, it's great to pass a certification quickly, but if it is too easy, hiring managers will know it. Certifications like the Certified Cybersecurity Specialist can be completed in just a few hours with minimal effort. Now, ask yourself, if it was that easy for you to get, how much weight do you think it holds with an employer? They know you didn't have to push yourself for it, and that's a red flag. If you can knock out a certification in a weekend, chances are it's not going to impress anyone in a job interview. So, you want a certification that shows the time, effort, and dedication employers are looking for as straight in a cybersecurity expert. At this point, you're probably asking, what certifications do I actually need to succeed? I'm gonna give it to you. So here it is, right? The moment you've been waiting for. This is it. Which certifications actually matter? If you're new to cybersecurity and looking to build a foundation, here are the certifications you should focus on, all right? Are you ready? Good. Number one is CompTIA Security Plus. This is the entry-level cert that almost every employer recognizes. It is often seen as the starter pack for anyone new to cybersecurity. If you're just breaking into the industry and need something to show employers you know the basics, this is it. Think of it as your cybersecurity foundation. It covers everything from risk management to network security and cryptography. Almost every job listing in cybersecurity at the entry level includes Security Plus as a requirement. So if you're asking yourself, where do I start? This is where, okay? Now imagine you're trying to build a house, but you've got no idea how to lay the foundation. Security Plus is like learning how to build that foundation so your house, or in this case, your cybersecurity career, doesn't collapse. It's not flashy, but it's solid. Number two certification you should go for is CEH, Certified Ethical Hacker. See, this certification is one of the most recognized certifications when it comes to penetration testing. Basically, the art of breaking into systems legally, of course, that has to be legal. Now, what makes makes this certification valuable is that it teaches you to think like a hacker. And in cybersecurity, the best way to stop a hacker is to think like one. Employers love this certification because it shows you can not only defend systems, but also anticipate how someone might try to exploit them. So with this cert, you are already one step ahead of the crowd. It even gets better because penetration testing is in high demand right now, and the skills you will learn with CEH are practical. Plus, since it's recognized worldwide, it opens up global opportunities, which means you are not restricted to working in one country or region. An all-around win for you right there. Now, moving on to number three, we have CISSP. That is the Certified Information System Security Professional. This one is considered the gold standard for anyone wanting to move up in cybersecurity, especially into leadership roles. It's not an easy cert to get. It requires at least 5 years of work experience, and the exam is known for being tough. But once you have it, doors start opening. CISSP shows that you understand security at a high level. We're talking governance, risk management, security architecture, and more. It's a certification that can lead to top six-figure salaries and leadership positions. But it's not just about understanding the tech. You get to demonstrate your knowledge of how to manage a company's entire security framework. So you become the person who can oversee an entire security across an entire organization, which makes you incredibly valuable. Employers know it's difficult, and that is why they're willing to pay top dollar for someone who has it. If you're serious about long-term career growth, CISSP is a must. And then number four is OSCP, Offensive Security Certified Professional. And I must tell you this upfront: OSCP is not for the faint of heart. This certification is famous for being one of the most hands-on and challenging certifications in cybersecurity. We are not talking about just theory here. OSCP forces you to prove that you can hack into systems in real-world scenarios. If you're serious about becoming a penetration tester, OSCP will show employers that you are not just someone who talks about hacking, you are someone who can actually do it. Imagine being thrown into the deep end of a swimming pool and told to figure out how to swim. That's OSCP in a nutshell. You are given a real-world challenge where you have to hack into systems, exploit vulnerabilities, and figure out how to break through defenses all under time pressure. Now, once you finish this certification, you've earned some serious bragging rights. Employers in penetration testing and red teaming look for OSCP like a badge of honor. If you've passed this, they know you've got the skills to handle real-world security breaches. I think of it like having a black belt in ethical hacking. That should have been the last certification I talk about in this video, but I have a bonus for you. So in number five is CISM, Certified Information Security Manager. If you're looking to go beyond technical roles and into management, CISM is worth your attention. This certification is all about managing and overseeing an organization's security program. While it's not as hands-on as OSCP or CH, it's highly respected for leadership roles where you're managing teams, budgets, and long-term security strategies. Now think of CISM as the certifications that says, I am not just here to fix problems, I'm here to lead teams that prevents them. It's ideal for people who want to move into cybersecurity leadership role as well. So we've spent the past few minutes walking through some of the certifications that have the most real world value. And I'm not in any way saying the list is limited to these, but there are several others like C-Risk, CISA, and much more. Basically, you just want to be sure that you are investing your time and money into certifications that will actually open doors for you in the cybersecurity field. Don't forget that certifications are tools. They don't make you an expert overnight, but they show employers that you've put in the work and you have the knowledge to back it up. The same way you are intentional about choosing the right certification, you need to be intentional about your entire journey in cybersecurity. It's not just about ticking boxes, it's about making smart, strategic moves that align with your goals. Certifications are just one part of the puzzle. The real key is continuously learning, gaining real-world experience, and keeping an eye on where the industry is headed. See, every step you take, whether it's earning a certification, tackling a new challenge, or even learning a new skill, should be building towards the bigger picture. And what's that? Becoming a professional who is not only skilled but indispensable. Okay, so we've covered a lot today. Everything from certifications that are too flashy for their own good to the ones that would actually help you land a job in cybersecurity. So here is my advice for anyone looking to break into the field. Do your research before committing to a certification. Don't just go for the shiny new cert because it sounds good. Look for certifications that are recognized, practical, and in demand. If you're ready to further explore which cybersecurity path is right for you, check out my other videos on the channel where I break down the different career paths in cybersecurity and how you can even get started. Even if you you have no prior IT experience. Trust me, you don't want to miss it. Also, don't forget to like, share, and hit the subscribe button for more content like this. And I hope I've been able to leave you today better than I met you. See you next time. Bye for now.